Annamacharya's application of stylistic and prosodic qualities of popular songs of his times to his own compositions is evident in many of his folk and colloquial songs. Annamacharya is also attributed with the credit of being the pioneer of bhajana sampradaya, congregational singing. There are several songs, particularly in the regions of Tamil Nadu, known as Thodayamangalams. These compositions have been in vogue from the time of Annamacharya and his son Pedda Tirumalacharya, his grandson Chinna Tirumalacharya. Those that are available now are the compositions of the grandson, which have influenced the Divyanama Sankirtanas and Utsava Sampradaya Kirtanas of Tyagaraja Swami. There is no doubt in my mind that Annamacharya himself was not known to Tyagaraja Swami, lest he would have mentioned him. Tyagaraja Swami mentions only Bhadrachala Ramadas among the Telugu composers and Purandaradasa among others. Purandaradasa 1484-1564, incidentally was a junior contemporary of Annamacharya 1408-1503. By the time Annamacharya passed away, Purandaradasa would have been 19, but historical evidences show that they met at least once, and Purandaradasa was greatly influenced by the works of Annamacharya. Let me quote a padam from Annamayya in Malavi. Sharanu Sharanu Surendra Sannuta Sharanu Srisati Vallabha Sharanu Rakshasa Garva Samhara Sharanu Venkata Nayaka. In the same raga, we find a composition of Purandaradasa bearing very striking similarities with the above. This is Purandaradasa's composition in Malavi. Sharanu Sharanu Surendra Vandita Sharanu Sripati Sevita Sharanu Parvati Tanaya Maruti Sharanu Siddhi Vinayaka. Now the comparison ends here. Both the Pallavis are in Sanskrit, but the composition of Annamacharya then jumps into Telugu and that of Purandaradasa into Kannada. But the comparison also does not stop with this song. There are many compositions in the Dasara Padagalu of Purandaradasa which bear a striking resemblance to the compositions of Annamacharya. Both of them, Annamacharya and Purandaradasa, dominantly dynamic in their own domains, deeply drenched in devotion, described Venkateshwara and Purandara Vithala respectively in all possible permutations and combinations. There are many songs of Annamacharya which are just a list of names. Exuberance rather than restraint is the common characteristics of literature of Annamacharya's times, and he could not escape from those effects and influences. Some of his compositions look grammatically sometimes erroneous. His songs were written for the ear and not the eye, for the soul and not the heart, for the mind and not the body, and for elevation from mundane and materialistic world. To achieve some musical effects, he perhaps had to resort to some kind of assonance, alliteration, rhyme and rhythm, and thus compiled to choose some words for their own sound and not the sense. There is a song, Marda Marda Mama Vandhani Durdanta Maha Duritani. It's an example to show how he has used alliteration. Marda means grinding, pounding, crushing, harassing, tormenting. Durdanta means unbridled. In essence, the sense is, crushed my bonds and my unbridled excessive sins. Similarly, there are many compositions where we find some unavoidable shortcomings, but that, however, is not a widespread characteristic of his compositions. There are compositions of exquisite beauty which bring about bliss by just even hearing them, even without music. As Narada says in his Bhakti Sutras, Lokeyapi Bhagavad Guna Shravana Kirtanat. Devotion is a quality, a characteristic, a state of mind which comes as you repeatedly think of him, sing his praise and think of his traits, his virtues and him. This is possible though otherwise we are surrounded by the worldly distractions and sensuous sensibilities all the time. Let us listen to this wonderful song, Marda Marda Mama Bandhani Durdanta Maha Duritani.
Marda Marda Mama Bandhani Marda Marda Mama Bandhani Marda Marda Mama Bandhani దుర్దాంత మహా దురితాని మర్ద మర్ద మమ బంధాని దుర్దాంత మహా దురితాని మర్ద మర్ద మమ బంధాని మర్ద మర్ద మమ బంధాని చక్రాయుధ రవిశత తేజోంచిత సక్రోధ సహస్ర ప్రముఖ చక్రాయుధ రవిశత తేజోంచిత సక్రోధ సహస్ర ప్రముఖ విక్రమ క్రమ విస్ఫులింగ కణనక్రహరణ హరి నవ్యకరాంక విక్రమ క్రమ విస్ఫులింగ కణనక్రహరణ హరి నవ్యకరాంక మర్ద మర్ద మమ బంధాని కలిత సుదర్శన కఠిన విదారణ కులిశ కోటి భవ ఘోషణ కలిత సుదర్శన కఠిన విదారణ కులిశ కోటి భవ ఘోషణ ప్రళయానల సంభ్రమ విభ్రమ కరళిత దైత్యగణ రక్త వికిరణ ప్రళయానల సంభ్రమ విభ్రమ కరళిత దైత్యగణ రక్త వికిరణ మర్ద మర్ద మమ బంధాని హితకర శ్రీ వెంకటేశ ప్రయుక్త సతత పరాక్రమ జయంకర హితకర శ్రీ వెంకటేశ ప్రయుక్త సతత పరాక్రమ జయంకర చతురోహం తే శరణం గతోస్మి ఇతరాన్ విభజ ఇహ మాం రక్ష చతురోహం తే శరణం గతోస్మి ఇతరాన్ విభజ ఇహ మాం రక్ష మర్ద మర్ద మమ బంధాని దుర్దాంత మహా దురితాని మర్ద మర్ద మమ బంధాని మర్ద మర్ద మమ బంధాని మర్ద మర్ద మమ బంధాని